May 6, Monday of the third week of Easter. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. After Jesus had fed the 5,000 men, his disciples saw him walking on the sea. The next day, the crowd that remained across the sea saw that there had been only one boat there, and that Jesus had not gone along with his disciples in the boat, but only his disciples had left. Other boats came from Tiberias, near the place where they had eaten the bread when the Lord gave thanks. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered them and said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father, God, has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." The Gospel of the Lord. Do not work for food that perishes. In the Gospel, Jesus offers to the people who have eaten of the loaves and fish he had multiplied food that endures for eternal life. In contrast to the bread that can satisfy the hungry stomach, the food of Jesus satisfies the deeper hunger of the human person. Food for the belly is perishable, good for earthly life that ends with death. But the food that Jesus offers is nourishment for another kind of life, life with God that finds its fullness in the life beyond death. This is eternal life. But eternal life is not just a reality beyond this earth. Eternal already characterizes this present life anchored in faith and love of Jesus and in living his commandment of love. Eternal life is a life in the age to come. Yet, it begins as a person is baptized in Christ, knows him, and bears witness to him. This life is already characterized by the tension of the already and the not yet.